Alright, I'd like to thank everyone for tuning in to our Morning Glory live stream. And today's message is entitled, What's the Judas in You? What's the Judas in You? And sometimes we as being believers or call ourselves Christians or leaders in Christ, we tend to forget the weakness or the betrayal that we do to others in the name of leadership, in the name of friendship, in the name of family. And so what happens is that we betray others but think that we are helping them. No matter what you say to others about somebody, if you haven't said it to them first, if you haven't had a conversation with them, if you hadn't mentioned it to them in their face, then you're a Judas. So when we talk about what's the Judas in you, we're talking about that thing inside us that betrays others, but we don't want to be betrayed. We like to talk and listen about keeping it real, but we have become the most deceitful and evil people on the earth. See, we'll talk about people, and then we'll come to those same people and smile in their face and ask them for help and ask them for advice. But all the time, you get what I'm saying? We betraying them. I remember even earlier this year, you know, I was telling somebody, hey, I said, hey, this man stole my conference idea. And here this man gonna do a war conference all for 6-7 years. And all of a sudden, you're going to change the name to This Means War. I didn't say he wasn't doing it. I said he changed it. You should have seen how many kinfolks and people who say they're connected to me, they went gathering information for things on his side. They thought, I don't know. I see everything, but don't say nothing. So you see, those are the kind of people that even though they're your friends, they're your family, they're your ministry associates, those people you talk to, them the kind of people that would have cut your back out quick before you even blink your eyes. Them the kind of people are change sides to whoever giving them something they need at their time. People with that Judas spirit, they wishy washy. Oh, if they can get somebody, if they can get somebody you, but yet still hold on to them, they gonna play both sides. We got people like that in ministry. You got leaders like that. You got family members like that. You got husbands and wives like that. You got boyfriends and girlfriends. See, we got to look at ourselves, who we betraying. See, it really, I can care less who talk about me, who take people's side against me. Because one thing I know, you never hear me asking nobody for a thing. You never hear me crying out, can y'all help me do this? Can y'all help me do that? Because a Judas is somebody who wants everything and possesses nothing. Matthew 26:14 says, then one of the 12 called Judas. Let's go. Let me read this whole thing right quick. So, because I got other stuff to do. Watch this. For ye have the poor always with you, but me ye have not always. For in that she have poured this ointment on my body, she did it for my burial. Verily I say unto you, whosoever this gospel shall be preached in the whole world, there shall also this, that this woman hath done, be told for a memorial of her. Then one of the 12, called Judas Iscariot, went unto the chief priests. So what we saying, that's Matthew 26:11-14. A Judas is a backbiter. They'll see you doing something they can't do, and they'll go get people to plot up against you. You know what I'm saying? So when he said, then one of the 12 called Judas Iscariot went into the chief priest, who you going back plotting up against somebody else? Who you talking back behind their back? See, it kills me. People get on social media behind pulpits and all this talking about how holy it is. Who are you talking about behind their back? People get upset at me sometimes my directness, because if I got something to say to you, I'm just going to say it. I got a lot of people who say, why you hate me? I never told you I didn't hate you. I just don't care for you. But if you never come to me and ask me why, then you'll never know. So if you think I got something against you, you come to me and ask me. See, that was wrong. We ain't honest with nobody because we want something from them all the time. We got to understand that you, everybody on this world got a Judas spirit. The reason I say that is because in some way or another, it's somebody you talk about all the time, and you never go to that person and tell them how you really feel. I was saying something yesterday how people will be attracted to your anointing and can care less about your ministry. That means they just around you for your revelation, for watching you operate, but then you in ministry, they don't help you do nothing. But I follow you. I believe in you, but they don't help you do nothing. You don't even send them $10 and say, hey, prophet, keep it up. Hey, pastor, keep it up. Hey, pastor, you don't help them do nothing. And I look at people, sometimes, especially these women, they go around here preaching. They got all that caked up makeup on their face. They look like hell on earth. But you never see other women. See, I ain't got, now if y'all wear your makeup, y'all go ahead. But you got all these other women around her. They got their makeup applied perfectly. And here they is, got stuff that ain't even a part of their skin tone. A dark person ain't got no business wearing dark makeup. And I'm a man, can see that. But even the Bible says you're supposed to be shamefaced. Just clean your face. Never mind. Backbite. What's the Judas in you? Why you around here giving gossip, giving words, giving exhortation, giving revelation, giving wisdom? If you can't identify with the weakness in you, you don't have the power to preach strength in other people. Stop walking around here like you got it all together. Matthew 26:25 says, get to it. What's the Judas in you around here betraying people, but you still need their help? Man, go on all that. That Matthew 26:25? What in the world? Y'all bear with me. My computer acting up. There you go. Then Judas went and betrayed him. Wait a minute, Wilford. Matthew 26:23 said, and he answered and said, he that dippeth his hand with me in the dish, the same shall betray me. The Son of Man goeth as it is written, but woe unto the man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It had been good for that man if he had not been born. Verse 25, then Judas went, which betrayed him, answered and said, Master, is it I? He said unto him, thou hast said. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread, blessed it, and gave it to the disciples, and said, take, eat, this is my body. Watch this. Ain't it funny, the same people that talk about you, the same people that portray you, the same people that gossip about you, it's the same people that you done ate dinner with? You ate lunch with, you sit down and have meaningful conversation with, it's the one closest to you that's always betray you. Then watch the manipulation. Is it I? People get on social media, go to their friend, talk about you behind your back, and then when you say something about it, you talking about me? Watch this. When people say something that you don't know they should be saying and it's convict you, you ain't got to guess that they talking about you. Your conviction should tell you enough they know what you're doing. He told Judas to go do what you got to do. That's what I tell them. If you're going to be in leadership, you got to have a thick skin. If you're going to preach this gospel, you got to have a thick skin. People going to talk about you. They call me false prophet, all, especially when I first started, all the time. Don't listen to him. He don't know what he's doing. He don't know what he's saying. But the fact of the matter is, I use scripture and tell you the truth and say, hey, you go study, which means I ain't telling you to believe what I'm saying. But watch this. If what I speak through the spirit bear witness with your spirit, that's all the agreement you need. People gonna call you everything. They call Jesus everything. Ain't no need in defending yourself. Let them say what they gonna say. What's the Jesus in you? Who you lying about? Who you tricking? Who you around here asking favors from? Listen here. I hate people that will come get a favor for you for free, but then they'll go somewhere else and pay somebody. That's a Judas. You want what I got to offer. And what I told somebody, I said, I ain't gonna take my $42 steak and trade it for a $6 bag of chips. What that mean is, I pay good money for anything I use, especially when it's coming to doing websites and all that mess. Anything I buy, nine times out of ten, unless I find it, it gonna cost $400-$500 or more. Don't come to me asking me what the cheapest I can do it for. If you want something cheap, go somewhere else. Because I'm not finna spend top quality merchandise, money on top quality software to put out top quality merchandise, and you want me to do it at the cheapest I can. Ain't no way in the hell. Yeah, I say it is. What I'm saying, a lot of you that's in business, if a person come to you and talking about what the cheapest you can do it for, and you know you done pay, now you done got your stuff from Walmart or that little $5-$10 stuff they sell on the internet, you know, whatever. But when you know you buy good stuff, and you in business to make money, and you buy good stuff, and you know your stuff good, stop taking customers that want something for cheap. That's a spirit of poverty. You rather not do the work than do the work for less than what you think it's worth. Stop lowering your gifts and talent just to make somebody else happy. That's like me paying. And watch this. If God wants you to do something for somebody for free, he'll put it in your spirit. Stop letting these people tell you, especially these church folks, to come to you talking about, you ought to do it for free and bless me. If God wants you to bless somebody and you in business, God going to tell you who to bless. Stop dealing with people who always want a discount. Stop looking for people who want the best quality work for the less price. I don't even know where I'm getting on it. Somebody need to hear. I was talking about Judas, but this good too. That's people who betray you. And just because it's your family, friend, a ministry, associate, you ain't got to give them no discount. Because watch this. They'll go pay $400, $500, $600, $700 for them rolls. They'll go pay top dollar for them suits. But then when the stuff they want to market, they minister in, they want to come to you and ask for free. Ain't no way in the world. Stop belittling your business just to get business. You want me to? They come to me talking about book publishing. I treat you like you pay. That's why you, when you get top quality software, you able to manipulate your prices to what people want. But I ain't finna get you, gang. I ain't finna come off the top shelf with, and you want to give me $20. They go pay $600 for these cell phones. They pay 50, 60, 70, 80, well, they pay $200 a month for these cell phones. They can do it if they want to. So who you around here manipulating, trying to get something for free? Judas, you betraying your own business just to get a little money. If you in business just to make money to pay bills, then you don't need to be in business. You should be in business because you love what you do. What's the Judas in you? Who you betraying? A lot of y'all betraying yourself when it comes to love. You know that boy don't care nothing about you. All you is a mattress tester. On time he call you when he want to get him some. But you at work, my boo love me. You know she don't care nothing about you. All she wants you for is to pay her bills. She don't care nothing about you. Betraying your own self. Now when they leave you and get somebody else, you want to cry because your heart broke. You better be glad God allowed you to see the light. We working jobs, we working jobs, but on social media, I 7 hours out of the day. Them people paying y'all to do work. You can't be on no company computer, on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter. And doing live videos on the clock. But then you want to pay God to be. God says you got to be obedient to your masters. Brown is stealing ink pens and post-it notes. That's stealing. See, it's the little foxes that spoil the vibe. Y'all don't think about it. You on Instagram on their computer all day. Watch this. When them white folks want to fire y'all, all they got to do is go to the computer department and say, hey, pull up so-and-so computer number 123. And they can see every screenshot, every word that you ever. I know what I'm talking about because my cousin did it for years. I used to go back there and show me what people saying. You think you be sneaking on Facebook because you might know a little something. You ain't doing nothing on these people's computer they don't know about. They gonna pull up all of that. Then they gonna call you in the office. How you doing? And you know, they tell me, okay then, well, we pay you to work 8 hours and it seems like you was carrying on a conversation in your inbox on Facebook. I guess we got to fire you there because it's illegal use of company stuff. Now you gonna go home and get on Facebook and say the devil wanted me losing job. No, fool, you was on them company. Y'all can't be on these. You cannot be in these folks' jobs on this social media. They paying y'all to work. Watch this. So the time, the 2 minutes or whatever you spend on social media, they count that as productivity loss. And these people losing money, guess what? Where you going? They don't need you if you ain't finna do their work. I don't even know why I got on this, but it's good too. We might have to finish this one. Some of y'all gonna get fired. And y'all heard it from me first. Because in the way the economy is, they already trying to cut back. So to keep the people, watch this. I got a friend in New York. they were doing something with a school. They called her in, and she built the school from the ground up, got the computers in there running, showed them where to get grants from, this and that. They fired her just to keep the people they hired that's over her in place. They fired her. Talking about they can't afford her salary no more. And she wasn't making nothing. And it's because the head man had just bought a house. So they got rid of her position just to keep him. A lot of y'all, they finna get rid of her. Because they looking, I guarantee you, they going over now trying to see how much inactive productivity, because you want to be on Facebook. Ooh, Brother Hubbard show is saying something good. You listen to me at home, because you ain't coming to me talking about, can I borrow $20 from gas? When you on these people job, you on these people job. You can, if you on your, you can't be on your cell phone and you supposed to be working too. You either you get on them cell phone when you got your 15 minute breaks and your 30 minute lunches. Other than that, do not use these people. I'm trying to warn y'all. You gonna mess around and get fired. Then you wanna blame it on the devil, but you don't see your disobedience. I told my other friend, he was doing a video, because he my friend, I like for him to keep his job. He did a video and he was driving. I said, hey, don't do that no more. Because you, even when you drive, you don't know where a computer at or a camera at, and these people coming to truck. I said, you did a good video, but it looked like you was driving. I said, next time, either be still or get outside. I forgot what I said. Get outside. Don't do no video in these people's truck, and they look up there, and you might have a wreck, and they look at the computer, or they got them in dash cameras or whatever. Oh, you was doing a Facebook live video, and you caused that wreck. These people ain't stupid. They got they self cover. I mean, you cannot be on a job and think you getting away with it. Now back when I was working, the way the building was set up, they had these about 5 inches crack up against the wall. Man, we used to get over there and get against that wall and put boxes in front of us, and we'll sit there and go to sleep. But y'all can't do that now. Cameras and technology everywhere. So what's the Judas in you? Who you cheating out of money? You getting these people money for 8 hours worth of work, and 6 hours you on Facebook. 2 hours you on Instagram. If you on the clock, you can't be on the clock preaching this gospel. I know you like it, but you're gonna get fired. Watch this. Just because your supervisor say, don't mean the company, the person who owned the company say. Around him beating people out of money, and then you wonder why you keep praying for a blessing and it never comes. Because he ain't gonna give you no blessing, you disobedient on your job. Everything to God go hand in hand. So to him, they're like, you stealing money. He appreciates you preaching the gospel, but you stealing money. I know you like the gospel. You better wait till you get home. All right, I lost my train of thought. Y'all be blessed. Have a good day.